think that Method Black is going to be able to take this. The blind pick starts now.
Yep, this is going to be very interesting. I was actually going to guess Temple Storm might lock this in. Method Black actually showed this composition against the team formerly known as Ascendant, making a movie, and it does quite well into RMP. We'll have to see if they can pull it off against a team like Method Black.
Indeed, JB going to be on that DH, Alec on that Affliction, Warlock, and Mimpoike on the Restoration Charms. So triple ults coming in against Method Black's full triple main team, and they find a Kitty Short Sheep. It actually gets spell-locked, and Raikou actually gets the Ring of Frost onto Jamie, but no Sheep on the Mimpoike. Jamie with a beautiful double stun on the chest, and Raikou, and negate their opener from Method Black completely.
Yeah, Alec taking a little bit of damage. There's a full blind on Mimpoike with the smoke bomb. Big burst coming in from Method Black onto Alec. He doesn't have the trinket. He's playing the Orc Relentless, looking for the Fears now with the Reflect. Managed to land one. Good pressure coming in from Jamie onto Raikou. Full Fear on Chaz. Oh. Can they get the first Ice Block? They do manage to get it. Temple Storm not looking too bad.
Indeed, Jamie with that Metamorphosis was able to crush Raikou through and get that Ice Block. He's doing it, the Crossfire damage onto Waz as well. Chaz having to use his Rapture and Pain Suppression right now. They're in a lot of trouble. Temple Storm have been firing up some pressure onto Raikou and Waz, and they're in a lot of trouble. The cheap shots come out. Kidney onto Poike. There's the full Sheep. They need a pressure Alec now or never. There's the frozen orb, but he gateways away, and Waz is in a lot of trouble. He has the defensives to survive. The stun onto Raikou is good. A fear on the Mimpoike right now. Alec still not out of the waters yet, but after this Sheep, maybe Mimpoike can heal him. Waz and Alec are still very low. Alec not using that demonic resolve. The healing tide comes in. Will it be enough? He uses that Hellstone to well. A major defensive cooldown for Alec to live there.
Yep, baits a little bit of damage. I don't mind that play whatsoever. Alec's going to be topped off. Interrupt coming in. Raikou looking for some damage, but Jamie still all over him in this matchup. Chaz gets interrupted. Good pressure coming in from Temple Storm once again, but Mimpoike really struggling to top off Alec in this situation. But still, Temple Storm has decent pressure. Polymorphs coming in from Raikou onto Jamie. Good control from Method Black. Alec still just kiting for his life.
Raikou got caught out by it to get down. He uses that second ice block. Alec getting so much pressure on a Raikou there. And all of a sudden, Raikou doesn't have any more spell locks. He uses the icy veins, but nothing's really happening. He actually misses his AWP onto Alec, and he gateways away. Alec might be able to survive because of that Mimpoike catching him up with the heals. He has the Spirit Link and the Ascendance as well. Method Black are all of a sudden in trouble.
Raikou is in so much trouble. He has nothing left. If they can get a fear onto Chaz, Jamie might be able to take him down. And Mimpoike in a good position right now. Waz looking for the re-stealth. Alec's going to be denying. See Chaz just preemptively healing as much as he can with that clarity of will. Waz looking for some damage on Alec, but it's just so difficult. You're playing an Orc, you have Relentless, you have your Port. Anytime they find the damage, Alec's just able to kite. Nice interrupt coming in from Raikou. Looks like Waz looking for a stun on Mimpoike, but you can see Mimpoike excellently just line of sighting him.
Yeah, Jamie getting a lot of pressure on Raikou with that Fell Barrage and the Fell Eruption stun onto him. Mimpoike get put into the blind now. Will he trinket it? Raikou looking for an Ebon Bolt right now. He gets spell locked on it. He's so low on HP, the Temporal Shield. Massive healing coming through, and now they reverse the pressure onto Jamie, but beautiful fears onto Waz from Alec. They're gonna deny the pressure, and Jamie doesn't need to use any defensives. They find a capstan into a hex onto Chaz. Raikou's in so much trouble.
No way.
The windshield
is
gonna take him down. Surely Chaz with the Rapture Shields, he's able to survive, and now but by the skin of their teeth.
That was so scary. Chaz now has his trinket, so it's not gonna be as scary, but big burst coming in from Jamie onto Raikou. Raikou has just been forced so defensive in this game, not being able to get any polymorphs over on Mimpoike. They just really haven't been able to find the damage. Kidney shot now on Mimpoike. Waz trying to make something happen, but big burst on Raikou. Fear on Jazz, and Temple Storm has done the impossible. They go up 1-0 against Method Black.
You need to actually think right now at home about how crazy that victory is. Yes, it is only the start of this series, but just think about Temple Storm on land right now. I'm going to be completely honest. I was incorrect about this team. This was a team that I really did not even have in my mental conversation as being one of the top teams, but when they're playing like this, they are looking so scary. And we already know, like I brought it up once before, this is probably the scariest team going into a new expansion. I mean, look who you have on your team. You have Alec. He's brilliant. He's an innovator. When he gets in situations like this, we already saw what he could do at Blizzard.
Moments in the game, and here is one of them. I mean, we can take a look at Poike here on the Shaman, managing to squeak in a beautiful hex here onto Chaz. You see Alec here is setting up for that triple CC, and and Jamie, he's getting ready to launch that attack onto Raikou, and this is the second ice block of Raikou. Chaz already used all of his cooldowns, so this is such a great setup here from Tempo Storm. There's the full fear onto Waz. I mean, Poike has that Hex as well. He's moving forward to get those purges. Jamie's gonna come out of that crowd control and...
By one, will they be able to find themselves on match point? I mean, if they play like they did in the last one, I think it is a very real outcome. EU looking absolutely insane.
Indeed. Attic actually getting stunned on that gateway. That's actually a huge opener for Waz on the Allure. He gets bashed up. Attic gonna be trying to get that gateway, but it's unavailable, and that could be a big opportunity for Everback to take this again, put into that sheep. It looks like he'll be tunneling down Waz the majority of the game on that Outlaw Rogue Frost Mage. So a very interesting composition coming out from Everblack.
Yeah, Alec gets done behind the pillar. Nice disarm coming in from Nyxie. Alec should be fine with the situation. Minpoike in a good position right now. But like you said, Alec not having that gateway is going to be very, very scary.
Oh, that was a beautiful storm onto Waz. And he fears his trinket when he stuns Minpoike. Excellent play. But Minpoike crushed through this. He gets completely destroyed through that basket, ends up having to use that trinket, and now there's a scenario where he could get a full blind onto Minpoike. Alec has no trinket as well. This is so much trouble for Tempo Storm.
Method Black needs one good setup. Nyxie has no trinket. Good pressure out onto him. If they can get a good setup on Nyxie with the Icy Banes or another swap over on Minpoike, goodbye that Resto Druid. Alec has no trinket as well, so this is really Method Black's option. Full blind now on Minpoike. Good pressure coming out. Can they find their target? Looks like they want to set up on Minpoike out of this Sap, cheap shot on the Nyxie. Raikou looking for an Ebon Bolt. Who's he gonna get it on? Full stun on him and Poike. So much damage. There's no chance that he lives this. Method Black strikes back.
That was textbook Method Black right there. Just completely annihilating him from the start of the game, stopping that gate to getting the kill onto Minpoike. Absolutely perfect, perfect play from start to finish.
Yeah, that's the Method Black that we know and love. Definitely coming out swinging there, and now we're going to be all tied up. And Zico, what does this really say about the series here, seeing that explosive game two from Method Black?
I mean, it looks like Method Black are a little bit pissed over that first game because they brought in the heat. They catch Poike out of form, commit the Plunder Armor, force out his trinket, similar to what they did in their series against Super Rejects in that last game. They pop onto Envious, he trinkets out, then they blind him, and then they go onto somebody else. Well, in this case, when you blind Poike out of form, and also he doesn't have that bark skin, you don't need the Plunder to actually kill him after that. All you need is your mage, who still has his Icy Veins, to come and press Frozen Orb with Icy Veins and maybe get a few Ice Lances out of there. And that's all it takes, really, for Poike to go down there. And if Nyxie can't rise to the occasion there and pull
like this, but definitely don't want to feel like you made the wrong call. And Poike did a great job in game number one, unfortunately getting caught a couple times here, but it's difficult in the situation when you're going up against a team like this that just have such solid offense.
Yeah, and I just...
about to find out as the gates open.
Yeah, only time will tell. If we can see Temple Storm get big pressure against Method Black, it's going to be a good choice. If not, obviously, maybe not necessarily the best pick. Waz going to be charging in right away. Jamie knocks him out, but a full pistol stun over on Alec. Once again, stopping the gateway, just so important, but Waz is doing an excellent job.
Indeed, using that Outlaw Rogue to his potential, just getting that grip or that hook all the way there, and the range stun to stop those gateways is going to cause a lot of havoc. Alec gets kicked up as well. Witcher onto Jamie's Fel Barrage, going to deny a lot of pressure. A stun onto Minpoike right now. It looks like they're going to go onto Alec. Minpoike has the Earth Shield on himself. Alec looks okay right now. He gets stunned. Jamie dropping incredibly low. He gets mind control downstairs. Swampsy doing an exit drop, completely soloing him. The other mind control as well. Minpoike is unable to get it. They stun Jamie. He gets stunned on his trinket. He has to use the blur right there. Maybe more, but it looks like the trinket blur is enough. But this is a very promising start for Method Black.
That was such an insane setup. Jamie getting soloed down into the root. Out of the root, Waz comes over and stuns him out of line of sight. Very excellently done. Precision setup there by Method Black. Gouging out over on Minpoike. Jamie's in a lot of trouble. He has no trinket, no blur. Definitely an opportunity there for Method Black. In the meantime, Waz taking a little damage. He still has all his defenses. He should be completely fine.
Indeed, it just looks like they always like doing this as the Outlaw Eddie. Swapsy just bringing back that melee and kind of soloing him with Chaz. Meanwhile, Waz is just on that caster, locking him down, shutting him down, and creating havoc between the healer and that ranged DPS. And they make a huge swap onto Jamie. They winch him in Poike as well, doing a lot of damage onto him. They don't commit anything right yet. The defensive stun onto Wasty. Trinket's out of it. It looks like they're trying to kill Jamie right now. He has his defensives needed. The DR sap comes in on the Minpoike with that cheap shot. And it looks like Jamie is okay for now. Minpoike really needs to top up against Coin of Fear as well. He maybe came back at the wrong time, but it looks like he's just about going to survive. I don't know. Minpoike is just spamming out those healing waves. Gouge comes out, and it looks like they're going to stabilize.
So much pressure from Method Black. They are all over the place in this matchup. Alec taking a whole bunch of damage as well. Jamie struggling to find pressure. Doesn't seem like this is the composition Temple Storm really needed or wanted. Interrupt there now on the Swapsy. Full Fear on the Chaz. Can they find some pressure off of this? Gouge onto Alec. Who's a good target? Jamie, no trinket available. Stun over on him and Poike. Watts trying to create some pressure there. In the meantime, Swapsy getting decent damage over on Jamie. He's the one with Earth Shield. Full blind now on him and Poike. Pistol stun onto Jamie. Big pressure, but unfortunately, Alex is there. He's actually playing the Mortal Coil, so good heals coming in from Alec. Spam Fears with the Death Coils in order to stop these setups from Method Black.
Indeed, Minpoike also using that trinket for the blind right now, so he's just able to stabilize and keep Jamie alive. And now Alec dropping a bit low, has the defensive coils. They make a swap onto Minpoike with the Earth Shield into the stun, but unable to get too much pressure. Beautiful stun from Jamie coming out onto Swapsy, denying pressure, but Minpoike is still very low. Jamie popping that annihilation as well. Minpoike is still so low. He pops down the Earth and Shield Totem. It goes away now. He needs to top himself, but Waz is just all over him, and Method Black are looking very dominant once again.
Yeah, Waz has the Plunder Armor. Minpoike, no trinket. If they can get one clean setup, the only thing that'll keep him alive is the darkness coming in from Jamie. Jamie needs to hold on to his trinket for that moment. That's what they need.
There it is.
There's the full stun on him, Minpoike. Plunder Armor hasn't been committed just yet. Doesn't look like he wants to use it. It's kind of a fake setup. Stun into Fear. Jamie could be in some trouble if they can get the stun onto him, but nice peels coming in from Alec with the Mortal Coil, with the Spam Fears once again keeping his team in the game.
That was a beautiful coil into a Fell Eruption stun from Jamie into that Fear to peel Waz, completely negating his use of utility, and that's exactly what they're going to need to be able to survive the Outlaw Rogue. A lot of pressure on the Swapsy right now. Chaz is free casting the heals, stun onto Minpoike. Alex dropping low as well now. He uses that Reflect on the Ice Tree. Well played by Alec. He's still getting bursted down. The Earth Shield finally comes out onto Alec. The triple DR stun as well. He gets that Fear. Full Fear onto Chaz. He actually pre-pre-esed during that Fear on the Swapsy to save the Astral Shift, but Alec getting really rolling right now. He gets kicked on his cast. Gouge on the Minpoike. He could just go down. The Urban Shield Totem might be enough. A defensive sap on the Chaz as well. Going to stop that Fear, but into another stun. Full Fear on the Minpoike. They might not be able to survive. The Hellstone might need to come out. He gets kicked again. No Demonic Resolve, and this is a good hold by Tempestorm.
Plunder Armor still being saved by Waz, saving it for a rainy day. Alex barely able to survive there. Really trying to get that pet out, but Method Black was able to shut it down for quite some time. Now stun over onto Jamie. Can they find the damage to force the trinket? Stun now over onto Minpoike. Swapsy casting out the Ice Fury. Big burst pressure coming in. Alex denies it once again with the Mortal Coil. That might be the talent they need to just stall out the game long enough. Minpoike does have the mana lead, so there is a clear win condition for Temple Storm.
Indeed, and Jamie's being so disruptive with the Fell Eruptions, and also his short cord on the imprisonments is just kind of stopping their flow of Method Black getting that offensive pressure, and he's doing another beautiful Fell Barrage. A full blind on the Minpoike is choosing to sit it right now. A lot of pressure coming in onto Alec and Jamie right now as well. No follow-up CC though onto Minpoike. A gouge onto Alec. It looks like they're going to survive that blind very easily.
Yeah, Alec gets interrupted. His Spellhunter is dead once again. Swapsy is doing an excellent job really punishing Alec for having that additional pet. Minpoike not able to heal it up. Unfortunately, now Alec and Jamie are a prime target. Fears coming in from Alec looking for the Spellhunter. Gets pistol stunned on it once again. You can see the little mind game between Waz and Alec there behind the pillar. Alec looking for the Fury. Gets kicked on it. Swapsy in a position to shut down the Spellhunter as well. If he can't get that interrupt, it's really going to be difficult for Templestorm to find pressure.
Alec dropping incredibly low here. Still not using that Demonic Resolve. The Urban Shield Totem comes out. Will it be enough? He uses that Hellstone as well. Good hold of the Demonic Resolve, but now using that crucial cooldown. Waz had the Plunder Armor as well. So great defensive read once again by Tempestorm, and they're still looking good. Dampen is just kicked in. Chaz is also going to be losing that mana. Well, Waz needs to make something happen. He stuns Jamie. He has nothing right now. He needs to trinket out of it. He does indeed, and he's going to just survive for now, but that was a huge defensive cooldown. Double stun onto Chaz and Swapsy as well. Jamie trying to create more pressure.
Yeah, when Alex Pet is dead, he doesn't have a gateway. So much of that Affliction Warlock utility is lost, so Method Black really shutting him down. Big swap on him in Poike once again. Can they get the Trinket Link? Stun into stun. Waz falls it up with the gouge. Do they have any more burst damage? An Earthshock stun or something, but a nice imprisonment by Jamie. Slow down Waz a little bit, allowing Minpoike a little bit of time. Top off his HP. Minpoike still ahead on mana. They just need to hold out a little bit longer. Swapsy actually forced to use that Astral Shift. This isn't looking too bad for Tempo Storm.
Indeed, Mepha Black actually opened that Trinket Rapture Archangel as well as the Astral Shift, but now Jamie's caught. He has no Trinket, and Poike has to save him. He's spamming out the heals, uses that Urban Shield Totem. He's going to stabilize right now. They need to be careful, but at the same time, Swapsy could be in a lot of trouble. He doesn't have the Astral Shift. Jamie is bursting him down so much right now. Spelllock on the Chaz as well. He is just gunning for him.
Yep, Jamie putting good pressure on Swapsy, but his positioning with Chaz has been excellent this game. There's the fear on Jamie. It looks like another swap on Poike. He's forced to Trinket as well as use that Astral Shift. Waz is going to have a Plunder Armor. If they can hold on 30 seconds, get a swap on him in Poike, they really have nothing for it except that key darkness from Jamie. So Jamie's going to have to come in clutch, but they cross crowd control him. He has no Trinket. Method Black has a huge opening coming up very shortly.
Indeed, Method Black could potentially take this game if they abuse the fact that they don't have any Trinkets. They have the Plunder Armor coming up soon. If Waz gets the coin debuff, he's going to be able to completely solo stun the entire team and get a kill, but it's going to come up in 5 seconds, so we're going to see a Maker move very soon. Alec getting a lot of unstable afflictions. Waz choosing to Cloak of Shadows and they'll top it. There's the blind. This is the go to kill, and it absolutely gets crushed by this Outlaw Plunder Armor. That was the perfect setup they needed. They forced the trigger from Mpoike, and then they were able to just set up cleanly onto Jamie. This is the Mepha Black we know.
Definitely is, and throughout the entirety of that game, I mean, it was just like, who are they going to go on next, and where are they going to be able to generate that pressure? Moving around, switching targets masterfully, but this has just been such a crazy series. I mean, game one, dominant on one end, then we see game two, dominant on the other. Then in this one, we start asking the question, was this the secret that Jamie alluded to in the interview? Was this composition their answer? Then halfway through that game, it kind of looked like maybe it was a secret that would have been better if it was kept. And then ultimately, Tempo then finds their feet again in that game. Although they're not able to win, they do find signs of life there. So maybe that composition does have a little bit of game, Zico.
Yeah, I mean, the composition that they pick is, there's no question about it. It's definitely a great composition, but you want to drag the game out late on the side of Method Black, and then Tempo has to answer to that. And then here, of course, is the second setup of the game. We can see here, Jamie doesn't have his trinket because he used it right earlier, and he has to be in the same positioning here with Chaz, and you can see that root right there onto Jamie is going to keep him in place to make sure that fear lands. There's a gouge onto Alec to stop that mortal coil, and then here Waz is finally getting his clutches onto Poike, and then we can see there's the full fear out of that root, and then there it is, big damage gonna land onto Poike with that tricks of the trade. And here is the thing about Waz as well, like, he does these setups even if he doesn't have the plunder armor, because he knows I'm gonna have plunder armor for a minute and a half later when they still don't have trinket, so we're gonna be good. We have plenty of time to set up a kill later. And then at this point, you force Poike's trinket and you force Jamie's trinket, and all it takes at this point is fear Jamie so he doesn't pre-blur, because if he pre-blurs, he's...
Will they be able to take this to a game five, or will Method Black send them down to the loser's bracket?
Yep, Method Black, they need to stop this crowd control from Alec and Poike and Nixie. If Chaz is caught in a crowd control, Swapsy will not survive long. Cheap shot onto Alec right away. Mpoike and Alec at some point are going to charge in, look for crowd control over onto Chaz. Full Hex coming in from Swapsy onto Nixie. That was very good. Now, you know, Nixie's not going to be able to land some damage for quite some time.
Waz actually peeling those Palamos to perfection there. Well played by Waz and the Alloy. And Swapsy's actually playing with that Primal Elemental, so he's going to have that Earth Mental Ellie stun on the team with them, but it will be overlapped a lot with the Waz Outlaw stun. So Alec getting very low right now as well. He pops that Temporal Shield, but it was very low. It looks like he'll be okay for now. Stuns on the mid point as well. Waz just gunning down Alec right now on the Outlaw, and it looks like they have a lot of pressure.
Yeah, Method Black actually having a field day avoiding crowd control. There's a full blind. They need some follow-up if they want to find any pressure on the Swapsy, but he's gone. He's out of line of sight. Look for a Hex. Alex with a nice interrupt and combust. Big pressure on the Swapsy. Disarm coming in from Waz onto Nixie, though. Swapsy able to survive a little bit longer. There's the Hodge outside of that Sap. Chaz able to find some healing there using his human racial to get out of that stun, topping off Swapsy, but no Astral Shift's going to be available. And keep in mind, Chaz has no trinket, so one more significant CC chain, Swapsy could be in a lot of trouble.
Indeed, the next Vendetta could be Swapsy's life, and it's a very interesting talent choice from Wes, playing with that Dismantle instead of Plunder now, so going for that defensive play, maybe to look to survive. Stuns on the Mpoike, Hex onto Nixie, he's going to get out of that. Full blind on the Mpoike, he's choosing to sit it right now. Alex around halfway tree, he actually trinkets it, pops that Avenger Crusader, looking to try and get some pressure on the Swapsy now. Meteor comes in as well. The full Hammer of Justice into Chaz, into a full Sheep as well. He was line of sight for the Pain Suppression. They need to get pressure on the Swapsy, but he's doing an excellent job kiting with those peels from Waz.
Yeah, Watch really shutting down Alok on this crowd control. Chaz gets out of the CC. And I really think Relentless is such a key talent here. DB into a DR Polymar. Swapsy all alone by himself. He needs to survive just a little bit longer. There's no more crowd control onto Chaz. He needs to get the cast out. Dismantle on the Nyxie. Alok getting low in the meantime. Blazing Speed's going to be used. Forced into the first Ice Block.
Yeah, indeed. That was huge. They got that Ice Block. Even though Swapsy was getting so MD. Up, they actually get it off. Alok might disrupt the dependence as he uses that Temporal Shield. They could just die through. So close to surviving. He just about gets it off. That was an insane play.
Yeah, but Temple Storm has nothing left. That was been Poike's bubble. One more crowd control. Alok could be all alone. There's the Earthshock stun. Stun on him in Poike. Alok all alone. Can they take him down? And Poike with the blessing of protection. Swapsy purges it off. Looking for the closest move out. Getting shot on Swapsy. Nyxie flailing to keep his teammate alive. Alok trying to run away. Pistol stun comes in. And Method Black will close this series out. 3-1 against Temple Storm.
Just absolutely running away with that series. And they're going to go to the upper final now because of it, and they're sending down a Temple Storm that in that first game looked absolutely insane. In their first series looked bonkers. Now down to the lower portion of the bracket to play against whichever NA team manages to come out on top. But Method Black, they really do find their footing there, Zico.
Yeah, and they do it in such a great fashion. They take down Temple Storm playing these kind of counter picks, taking a page out of the Jamili's book, essentially, where they played in the spring finals this Fire Mage Assassination Rogue Holy Pala and managed to actually dismantle Method Black at that tournament. Now they managed to actually overcome that, and I really, really like the adaptation to go without the plunder because the disarm is going to be a lot more valuable. You can disarm Nyxie when he gets a kidney shot, you can disarm Nyxie when he goes for the blind and to stop the sap. So it's a little bit more defensive, but your plunder armor is going to get Blessing of Protection. He's gonna get ice blocked. There's so many, immunities essentially on this.
One of the best rogues in the entire world, the best from NA, now the best from EU. Absolutely insane stuff. But my question really does come with Tempo Storm, right? I mean, we do see them play at a really phenomenal level. What do you think the rest of
this side here? I've got Chaz Live, the healer for Method Black. You just came off a victory against Tempo Storm. Was it surprising they were able to take a win off you in the first round? Did it really catch you off guard?
That combo they played is originally played by us, so we're a little bit surprised that they played it. But, you know, we just went back to our own DH lock and talked about how we would lose and win. And, we lost the first game. We played a little bit with a wrong mindset with the wrong talent, so that's why we lost the first game.
All right, glad to see that you had a plan for it. Obviously, there's a lot of healers at home that play 3v3, and I'm kind of wondering, what's it like to be the healer on your team specifically?
So my team is obviously, it has a really strong roster, but it can be really stressful as well, because there is a lot of pressure to do well in our team from everyone, from ourselves especially. So yeah, sometimes it's stressful, but it feels good to be in that situation sometimes too.
All right, you're looking good for tomorrow. Obviously, you're going to go back and take some rest, but do you have any sort of plans or strategies you're going to go over for tomorrow?
So we're definitely going to look over the VODs that the XRB had earlier. I don't think they have anything new to surprise us with, but they're definitely a really, really tough team for us. We just have to play well, honestly. The team that plays well wins, honestly, tomorrow.
All right, you heard it here. The team that plays the best will be the champions of this tournament. Rich, back to you.